I'm David Hill with New York Habitat. Today we're going to check out one of the coolest neighborhoods in Paris, the Marais, with its refined 16th century mansions, Jewish delicatessens, peaceful gardens, trendy boutiques. The Marais truly has something for everyone.
This will be the first of a two-part series on the fantastic neighborhood Le Marais. So be sure to subscribe to our YouTube channel and you'll be notified when part two comes out in a few weeks. The Marais, the French word for marsh, is located north of the Seine, sandwiched between Place de la Bastille, Place de la République, and Les Halles. Its swamplands were drained in the mid-1500s and was quickly bought up by the aristocrats to build their elegant city mansions. The area was abandoned in the 18th century when the nobles started gravitating towards the west of the city. The Marais would have seen the wrecking ball if it hadn't been for a campaign led by the Minister of Culture, André Malraux, in the 1960s to save the area's heritage.
Today, the Marais is one of the loveliest and trendiest areas of Paris.
You can spot two half-timbered houses hidden behind the busy Rue de Rivoli at number 44 Rue François Miron. Dating from the 14th century, these are the oldest homes in Paris. The building facades were plastered over in 1607 in compliance with a citywide ban on wooden houses and were only rediscovered in the mid-20th century. A lucky find for the surprised owner. Just to the north of Rue de Rivoli and east of Rue Saint-Paul is one of the nicest of the Marais Renaissance mansions, the Hôtel de Sully. Built in the 1620s, it was acquired in 1634 by Louis XIII's Superintendent of Finance, the Duke of Sully, giving the mansion its current name. Crossing this peaceful paradise of gardens, you can reach Place des Vosges through a secret doorway. Place des Vosges is most certainly one of the most beautiful places of Paris. Finished in 1612, it was commissioned by Henry IV to give crowded Paris a proper public square and became the model for squares all over Europe. The King and Queen's pavilions are located opposite each other on the north and south ends, and around the square are 36 attached townhouses built for the leading aristocrats of the era. Place des Vosges has had its share of famous residents, including Victor Hugo, whose home at number 6 is now a museum in his honor. Not everyone can afford to stay in Place des Vosges, but if you're looking to save money, consider renting a furnished vacation rental in Paris through New York Habitat. You'll get more space for your money, and cooking at home will save you even more. You can continue to track medieval Paris just off Rue Charlemagne, where you can see the largest stretch of the old city wall. The wall was built in the 1180s by King Philip August to protect against Viking invasions. Across the street from the old wall, take one of the open passages and you'll find yourself in another world, the magical village Saint-Paul. A series of building courtyards between the Rue Saint-Paul and the Rue des Jardins Saint-Paul, here you can pursue dusty antique shops, design boutiques, some art galleries, or stop for a glass of wine at one of the cool cafes. It's the perfect break from your stroll in the Marais. If you're looking for a bit of culture and history, stop in at the Musée Carnavalet, yet another beautiful private mansion home to the Museum of the History of Paris. Wandering its maze of rooms, you will travel through the ages of Paris, from the Roman times to the lively Belle Époque era from around the turn of the 20th century. And what's more, the entrance is completely free.
Well, my friends, I hope you've enjoyed our little tour of the Marais. And of course, there are a lot more things to do and see in this area. If I've forgotten any of your favorite Marais secrets, make sure you leave a comment in the comment section below.
And don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel so you can be notified when part two of our Marais video tour comes out in a few weeks. If you're planning a trip to Paris, live like a local by renting a furnished apartment through New York Habitat. Visit our website at nyhabitat.com. You're just a few clicks away from living like a real Parisian.
I'm David Hill with New York Habitat, once a muggy swampland and today a Parisian hotspot. I hope to see you soon in the Marais.